Hello everyone, this is Rishabh Singh. I'm a legal intern at Lexis & Company. Today I'm going to discuss about juveniles as sexual offenders. To start with, we always consider children as a face of God and hence we try to protect them. We always say that children are innocent and immature and so we try not to be harsh on them. But what if a child takes a face of a devil? Like, should we still consider them as same old innocent child? When a child or a juvenile commits a serious crime such as rape or any sexual offense, why are they not treated as actual criminals? Why are they not sent away? Why are they still treated as small children? So in this video, this video will try to open a door and will let you question the Indian justice system. It will also let you think, are these predators actually children who are immature and should not be treated as actual criminals? So in this video, it will basically help you to understand the consequences of not having strict punishments for juvenile rapists. It will also help you understand that age should not be used as armor by juvenile rapists, and that always letting them go without any strict penalty is not good for the future of India. According to NCRB, in 2017, in India, 1,456 sexual offences were committed by juveniles. Studies show that juveniles are not treated harshly because they haven't attained the maturity level or that they should be given second chance at life. In Nirbhaya rape case, when a juvenile was convicted, Ekanshi Gangli said, "Young people are easier to bring into an offense because they are easier to influence and brainwash. Then the same should be taken into consideration for adult rapists, because brainwashing someone and bringing them into an offense is easy." So I hope in this video this video help you to open a door for a new type of justice. According to Section 375 of the Indian Penal Code, rape is defined as a man that has sexual intercourse with a woman against her will, or when the woman is intoxicated and in no state to give her consent, or with her consent when her consent has been obtained by putting her or any person in whom she is interested in fear of death or of hurt. In simple words, rape in general is not considered when the victim is forced into a physical sexual act. It can also be defined when someone is pressurized, which as a result makes them feel that they have no option other than to have sex. Section 375 and 376 of the Indian Penal Code talks about rape and punishment for the same. In India, rape is without a doubt a heinous crime and an issue of great concern. According to National Bureau 2016 reports, rape is fourth most common crime against women in India. Madhya Pradesh has the highest number of rape according to the reports, in Indian state reports. When someone commits a crime like rape, we can say that they had full knowledge of activities that they are involved in committing such an atrocious sin. Along with the time, we have heard names like Akshay Thakur, Vinay Sharma, Pawan Gupta, Mukesh Singh, Mohammed Afroz, who was a juvenile, he was 17 years old. All of them were sentenced to death in the famous rape case known as Nirbhaya Hatyakand. Mohammed Afroz, he was set free after he served 3 years in the reform group. So he was set free after 3 years because he was a juvenile when he committed such a sinful act. Under the Juvenile Justice Bill 2000, any child in conflict with the law, regardless of the type of offense committed, may spend a maximum of 3 years in institutional care. The child cannot be given any penalty higher than 3 years, nor be tried as an adult and be sent to any adult jail. new bill was proposed in the House which treats all children under the age of 18 years in a similar way, except for one departure. It says that any 16 to 18 years who old who commits crime, heinous offense, may be tried as an adult. But what about the children who are under the age of 16 years? If they commit such a crime as rape, why shouldn't they be tried as adults? Why does their age save them from such sinful crime? So we as a society has failed to protect not only our girls but also our boys from falling prey to this route. We do have harsh laws for the adult offenders but who commit rape, but the problem arises where the rapists themselves are minors. Death penalty for life imprisonment or life imprisonment has expressly been forbidden as a punishment for minors below 18 years of age under Article 37(3) of the Convention of Rights of the Children, and also under Rule 17.2 of the United Nations Standard Minimum Rules for the Administration of Juvenile Justice, popularly known as Beijing Rules. Juvenile perpetrated sexual aggressions has been a problem of growing concern in Indian society over the past decade. So the concluding question that arises here that is that do we need cases like Nirbhaya gang rape and following protest for the acts to get amended? What if tomorrow someone is raped and accused is someone who is, say, 15 years old? Should they be allowed to escape the burden of the crime committed by them just because they were not of the legal age? Is that justice to the victim? Sexual offenses by young people should be seen within the context of an increased sexual crimes committed as a whole in the society. So this was all about the topic. Thank you so much.